Throughout the different wars America has had to fight, women have gradually started to take part in serving for their country. From World War I up to the Vietnam War, more women have become brave enough to volunteer their skills and assistance to aid the men on the battlefield and also at home. They have risked their lives, just like the men, but have never gotten the same amount of credit and rights overall. So, women have helped America during the Vietnam War by serving abroad to help the men and also fighting for themselves. All of the women in the Vietnam War were volunteers who were in their 20s to 40s. About 265,000 American women served in the military, and 11,000 women were stationed in Vietnam. They worked as nurses, physicians, air traffic controllers, intelligence officers, and clerks. They also worked on behalf of the American Red Cross, Army Special Services, United Service Organizations, Peace Corps, and other religious groups like Catholic Relief Services. Women also worked in the U.S. Women's Army Corps, U.S. Navy, Air Force, Marines, and the Army Medical Specialist Corps. Navy women served on hospital ships such as the USS Repose and USS Sanctuary off of the coast of Vietnam. Also, U.S. Air Force nurses cared for patients on evacuation flights. Overall, all these women stepped outside the conventional gender roles by traveling to Vietnam and putting themselves at risks and entering the male-dominant areas of foreign affairs. More specifically, women had a major role as nurses in Vietnam. About 90% served as military nurses throughout the Vietnam War. The U.S. military began recruiting women out of nursing schools in 1965. Many nurses entered the military through programs in which the government paid the cost of nursing school in exchange for a year of service in Vietnam. Julie Forsyth, a nurse during the Vietnam War, said, "The main opportunities for women in the American military were in the nursing and administrative fields. These women spent their long hours to aid the servicemen killed and injured in war, and spent their time treating wounded U.S. soldiers or Vietnamese people. They risked their safety to help these men, and as a result, many of them received injuries during battle, both visible and invisible." Many lacked practical experience. In fact, 60% of the military nurses who served in Vietnam had less than 2 years of experience, and 36% had less than 6 months. No one told them, nor could they know, they would experience a level of trauma in Vietnam that nurses had never confronted before in wartime, Laura Palmer wrote in the New York Times Magazine. Also, Catherine Marshall wrote, "Even nurses with backgrounds in trauma surgery were unprepared for the kinds of injuries they saw. For example, huge blast wounds were common, so were amputations of multiple limbs, and nurses frequently saw burns so severe that they went down to the bone. Thankfully and surprisingly, only 2% of the patients who made it to the American military hospitals died of their injuries or illnesses. But the downside to this meant that the men were left with many disabilities. This left many nurses with guilt. Although it salvaged lives, this system also created a dilemma about the quality of life left for some of the men," Norman wrote. Nurses spoke of the guilt and confusion they felt when they sent severely disabled patients home. Overall, 8 female nurses died during the Vietnam War. They risked their lives and also saved many men's lives at the same time. They were heroes. When women got home from the war, life was not as great as they had hoped. They faced hostile and unfriendly treatment. They also had a hard time talking about their service. Women felt alienated from society and felt like no one could understand their feelings. "You didn't feel there was anything you could ever enjoy again because you were really immersed in death," Nurse Joanne Ferre explained. "Other people seemed shallow. You felt a strong allegiance to the dead." Many of them suffered from post-traumatic stress disorder, and they also suffered complications from Agent Orange. These women struggled to deal with their symptoms of either depression, flashbacks, nightmares, and/or angry outbursts. They also did not receive much support from the American people, the U.S. government, or male veteran groups. Because their numbers were smaller and because they had worked for such a variety of organizations, the women were more isolated than the men. Finally, in 1993, the women who served in the Vietnam War received some public recognition for their service. A bronze statue of 3 female nurses and a wounded soldier was dedicated in Washington, D.C., so people could walk by it and realize how important the women were during the war. Also, 5 nurses were awarded with the Purple Heart because they were injured during a Viet Cong bombing. These women were the first female members of the U.S. Armed Forces to receive that award in the Vietnam War. So, after the women got home from their service, a lot of them continued to suffer, and they barely gained recognition from their country. Over the course of the war, the U.S. had faced protests from the public that had turned the citizens' public opinion against the nation. The public opinion of America had been shattered and America's purity was taken away. Young people were drafted to fight a war in Vietnam and many ended up being killed. More specifically, women volunteered to fight for their nation. They risked their lives to help men at war and also America. They experienced wounds that doctors today could have never imagined. Blast wounds, amputations, and burns to the bone are just a few examples. They saved many men's lives. The nurses were left with trauma from just operating on these men. then, but when they were allowed to come back home, the nation seemed ungrateful. A majority of America barely even knew that women fought. They received hostile treatment from citizens while also experiencing PTSD and other mental illnesses, for example, depression. After risking their lives for their country, women received the bare minimum amount of respect and gratitude from their nation.